going to be able to organize a lot of household goods and clothing and books and children's toys that they get donated in a lot better fashion than having them piled up in boxes sitting on the floor. Kind of hard to figure out what they have and find things that they need. So this is a way to improve their efficiency in serving their clients.
I woke up this morning, saw a world full of trouble now. I thought, how do we ever get so far down? And how's it ever gonna turn around? So I turned my eyes to heaven. I thought, God, why don't you do something? Well, I just couldn't bear the thought of people living in poverty, children sold into slavery. The thought disgusted me, so I shook my fist at heaven. I said, God, why don't you do something? He said, I did. Yeah, I created you. Now listen. If not us, then who? If not me and you, right now. Well, it's time for us to do something. Yeah. If not now, then when will we see an end to all this pain? Oh, it's not enough to do nothing. It's time for us to do something.
My name is Jack Hay. Me and my wife, we run the Healing Hands Ranch here. It's a 46-acre ranch that we bring in homeless men and other men that need to restart their lives. Well, to see our church community come and help us and volunteer, it helps us teach these men what it means to give back to society. Because if I can get their minds off themselves and on to who they can help, then they'll be able to recover themselves. So having the extra examples to come in and stuff and showing men working, it's just like reteaching a young man growing.
Talking about how we are God's hands and feet, but it's easier to say than to be. Live like angels of apathy who tell ourselves it's alright, somebody else will do something. Well, I don't know about you, but I'm sick and tired of life with no desire.
Methodist work day, and it's a work day for us. It's to beautify the prayer garden, to show people what we do around here, how we help the community, how we help homeless men, how we help homeless men get back on their feet and move forward with their lives with Christ as a right beside them.
Help y'all do
it
that.
Means the world to me. It does. It really does. It means there's people out there who actually care. Because I know when I was going through my situation, my homelessness and my addictions, I didn't think anybody was out there to help me. I thought it was just me doing it. It was going to be me. I was going to be the only person to get myself out of the hole I was in. When I found this place, I found heaven, to be honest with you. I found some people who were going to help me do what I needed to do to get me on my feet. And it's a godsend to know that there's somebody out there that's going to give you help. That's going to say, hey, not a handout, but a hand up, and say, this is going to teach me to fish instead of handing me fish to eat. So, yeah, it means a lot to me.
If not us, then who? If not me and you right now? It's time for us to do something.
Here and smiling, saying thank you, and very appreciative of the help.
We are the salt of the earth. We are a city on a hill. We're never gonna change the world by standing still.
pray for us. We've really enjoyed this.
The music is special, and we really, it's just really a good thing.
If not us, then who? If not me and you?
So why are we doing this? I think we're taking it to the streets because we're giving ourselves up for Jesus Christ because Christ gave himself up for us.